First off, let me say I apologize for the lack of programs. Things have been moving really fast this year for me with marching band and school and all that. So I really apologize. But this is the concert band. These are the kids here. First off, I just have to say that I'm very honored to be here with you tonight, and as the band director here at Hermiston High School, this year has been an absolute blast, and I've had a fantastic time with all of these kids. And I come to you from a small school in Washington State, southeastern Washington. Kind of in the city school district. I taught 5-12 band and guitar and drama and choir and did a lot of stuff. So I'm really happy to be here and just do band. It's very fun for me. So this is the concert band in front of you. This is a group of only freshmen. This year is a little bit different. We changed the format and we added another band, and we kind of split the symphonic band up in two. Most of the freshmen went into the concert band, and the symphonic band is our middle band, which really you'll hear second, and the wind ensemble is our top audition group. Each group will perform two selections for you, and this concert band, well, their first selection is entitled Red River Valley, and this is a old North American folk tune that dates back to the late 19th century, there's a long history, I won't get into it, but without further ado, this is Pierre Leplante's rendition of the Red River Valley.
Thank you.
So we're going to do a little switch around here. Our next piece of music is called Powhatan Rhapsody, and this was written by the Father and arranged by the Son, or vice versa. Not sure how exactly it worked out, but this is originally a Native American folk tune that Mr. Jose put together for concert band, and it kind of goes through a bunch of different variations along the way, and ends in a glorious climax. So, one thing I forgot to mention before we started was, if you haven't yet, please turn your cell phones on silent so that they don't go off in the middle of the performance. And if you need to get up and use the bathroom or get a drink of water or change seats, whatever, for whatever reason, please make sure that you're doing that in between performances or in between pieces of music so that we're respecting everybody else in the audience and as well the performers. So without further ado, here is Powhatan Rhapsody.
Thank you.
Okay, so it sounds like we're excited. Before we get started with Symphonic Band, I just wanted to thank a few people that have really helped me out so far this year. Those are the Booster parents. So can we get the house lights up? Maybe. There we go. Okay, so if you are a Booster parent, could you please stand up? So I hope that you noticed that there were only like a small handful of parents that stood up. The Booster Club is a really important organization for the band. It does focus a lot on marching band, which is what our main drive is right now. But they do other things for us throughout the year. They help us with going to festivals or paying for transportation, paying for reads, books, music, instruments. So if you are interested in helping out with that, they're always looking for more people to help out with either fundraising or becoming an officer. Please email hermistonbandboosters@gmail.com, right? Yeah, I got that right. That's hermistonbandboosters@gmail.com. And I think that's it for today. So, this is the Symphonic Band. The first piece that we're going to perform for you is called Canto by W. Francis Macbeth. And this is a pretty famous piece of music in the wind band world. It's kind of the first piece of music that really focuses on the pyramid of sound, which is the concept that you build the band off of the bottom instruments, and then everything else on top of that fits into it. So that's kind of what the whole piece of music was written about, and it's also a bit of an argument between the brass and the woodwind section. And the percussion section are just, you know, kind of holding us all together, just kind of checking along, doing percussion. You know, doing what percussion does best and hitting stuff. Okay, so without further ado, this is W. Francis Macbeth's Canto.
Thank you.
So this next piece of music is called March Diabolique, and it's written by a gentleman named Brian Balmages, who lives out of Massachusetts. And this is a piece of music that he wrote to kind of take the march and morph it into more of a sinister type of piece of music. And he based it a lot on the tritone, which if you're in music theory, you know that they used to have a really kind of demonic sort of, what's the word I'm looking for?
Connotation.
Yeah, connotation, that's it. So, okay, so this is a rather slow march, but it really builds up to a good yell at the end. So we hope you enjoy March Diabolique. Thank you. So, this is the wind ensemble in front of you. The first piece of music they're going to perform for you is a staple of the wind band literature. It's called Variations on a Korean Folk Song. The kids love it. It's their favorite. It's really my favorite, but it's also their favorite secretly. So, you're going to hear Erang, which is a Korean folk song. And you're going to hear five different variations, and the composer basically used all of his creativity to change it, flip the melody around, speed it up, slow it down, change the harmony, you'll see, hopefully you hear Erang all the way through if we did our job right. So here is Variations on a Korean Folk Song.
Short chorale.
Before we get to our final piece for the evening, I wanted to take a moment to recognize a few students. We will be sending, I believe it's 15 students to the OMEA District 6 Regional Honor Band this coming November 7th and 8th, I believe. We'll be going to Milton Freewater to do a mass band. If you are one of those students, could you please stand? And give them a round of applause. In addition to that, two of our students, Colton Katzel and Kyle Katchison, auditioned for WIBIC, which is the Western International Band Conference. That's up in Seattle. They made it into their Phoenix band, and it's going to be a fantastic opportunity for them. It's a four-day experience. They're going to get to work with world-class musicians and world-class composers. It's going to be a fantastic time up in Seattle. So, Colton and Kyle, could you stand up? So, our final piece for the evening is called Haven Dance, and this probably actually is the students' favorite piece of music that we're performing for this concert. This was originally written when David Holsinger was commissioned to write a piece, and he didn't really know what to write it for, and he noticed his daughter, who was about probably in her 5-6-year-old range, was starting to get into dancing and would dance around the house. And so he then came up with music for it, and it's, I've got to say, it's kind of a weird piece of music to have your daughter dance to. Not in a bad way, just not what I would see my daughter dancing to. But this is Have a Dance. We hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
safe and enjoyable evening, and may we all survive the next 3 weeks. Have a good night.